Hi, and welcome back to our channel on the college process. Once again, my name is Ed Zamora from Principia Prep, and today we're going to be discussing scholarships or grants, which financial aid resource is better, how to get them, the differences, and the pros and cons of each one. But before we start, if you are looking for more college content, please hit the subscription button below. It will notify you of new videos coming out, as well as if you do enjoy today's video, please leave us a like. It does help. That being said, let's discuss today's topic, scholarships or grants. Which is the better financial aid resource? In this video, when we are discussing scholarships and grants, I'm talking about the money provided to you by or distributed by the college itself, not a third-party group like a scholarships.com or something else online. First, let's discuss what are the differences between scholarships and grants and where do they come from. Now, you may be putting together your college list or thinking about putting together your college list, and you might be wondering if I want to receive any financial aid help at all. Before we begin, first, let's discuss or remind those who are new to the channel about the process of what the term financial aid actually means. Because the reality is financial aid means four things. It means scholarships and grants. This is the free money, the stuff you don't have to pay back. This is also referred to as gift aid. And then you have loans and work study, which are also part of financial aid or considered financial aid, but it means be paid back or worked towards, also known as self-help aid. For further details or insight, please watch our video, which I put in the description below, on the financial aid basics. Now, with that out of the way, as far as the basics are concerned, let's discuss the differences between scholarships and grants. Right off the bat, scholarships are typically guaranteed about 90% of the time to be given to your student over the 4 years they're in college. Usually, the recipient only needs to go to college full-time, essentially attend full-time, which is typically 12 credits or more, and maintain usually a 3.0 GPA or higher. Now, when it comes to grants, you typically need to show some sort of financial need. This will typically come from filling out the financial aid forms, like the Fafsa form, state forms, and in some cases, colleges will also require the CSS profile form. Now, if you have or show financial aid need, the college will look in some way to help you out with either institutional aid, i.e. the college's own funds, or also in some cases, federal and state funding as well, if you are eligible. Now, to receive scholarships, you typically do not need to show any sort of financial need. So what's more helpful, scholarships or grants? Well, both are free money, so both are helping you pay down the bill without having to pay something back or having to work for it. So both are good resources as far as reducing the cost without having to pay anything back, essentially. However, if you have the choice between a scholarship or a grant, I typically suggest families, if they are offered it for any reason by a college for the same amount, always go with the scholarship. Because once again, the scholarship is guaranteed for 4 years, almost 100% of the time, essentially. A grant is not guaranteed. Typically, the family must complete the financial aid forms every year in anticipation of getting the grant money, which means as income and assets go up and down, the grant can also go up and down, unfortunately. So you can technically lose grant money. So where does the money come from, scholarships and grants? Well, right off the bat, scholarship money is typically given out by the admissions office and usually does not require any additional paperwork as far as filling out any additional forms, but obviously double check with the admissions office. In some cases, there are special scholarships out there which do require an additional essay or some additional other paperwork based on the fact that in some cases they're set up by alumni or there's special circumstances around that scholarship that require more paperwork or more things being completed, in addition to just applying for the admissions of the college. So obviously, if you're looking for more information about scholarships, always contact the admissions office. They're open and willing to answer almost any question, especially when it comes to scholarship funding. So let's say you are asking some questions about the scholarship specifically, and they're looking at your profile and they say to you, you're not eligible for scholarship money based on everything they see. I would then ask, what do we need? A higher GPA, higher test scores, are you looking for more community service, etc. So you can see, is it even possible for you to get to a certain level, whether it be next year or the year after, to receive scholarship funding from that college. Now, if they say yes, you are eligible, they'll typically give you, as an example, a range of the scholarship fund you would be eligible for. So let's just say it's $5,000 to $7,000 or so is the range they give you. I would immediately, after they told you you are eligible and gave you a range of the scholarships you could be getting into, immediately I would be asking them, what is the next scholarship level? Is there a 7 to 10 range per se? And if there is, how do we get there? Do we have to improve the SATs, ACTs? Do we need more rigorous courses next year? Are you looking for a higher GPA? What is it the school is looking for? The first reason I'm asking is to obviously reduce the cost over the next 4 years by maximizing the scholarship eligibility out there. And the second reason I'm asking is to find out, is it even possible? As an example, if you have a 3.0 GPA and the next level of scholarship money is 3.5, probably not going to be able to happen over the course of a 1 year time frame. If you are, let's say, a 3.3 or 3.4, it may be possible. You can even ask the school, at a 3.3 or 3.4 GPA, if you do well academically in your senior year and get to the 3.5 or higher, will they use your senior year grades to provide you that higher level scholarship. Some colleges will do this. You want to ask as many questions of admissions as possible because it's better to be denied rather than not asking and not knowing, because you could ask and find out something that provides a doorway for more scholarship funding, i.e. reducing the cost of college and making it more affordable for your family. Now, grants, on the other hand, come from the financial aid office. And obviously, as I mentioned before, the FAFSA in all cases typically needs to be filled out. This is usually the starting point of all grant money being given out to families. Now, you want a better sense of what the school can give you, or a more, I guess, defined sense of what they can give you grant money-wise, rather than waiting to do the FAFSA, fill out the school's net price calculators. These will automatically give you a great sense point of view of what that school will give you in grant money. We also have a video, Understanding the College Cost and the Expected Family Contributions and Net Price Calculators, down below, as well as here in the video, the link down below in the description as well, which gives you more insight and understanding of how the net price calculators works to give you a better sense of what they can provide you in grant funding. So now let's talk pros and cons. Well, for scholarships, as far as the pros are concerned, scholarship money will be guaranteed for 4 years, regardless if the family's income goes up or down. Now, the con, as far as the scholarships go, the scholarship money will not increase no matter how well your student does academically at the college. They can't get additional scholarships at the college, but scholarships are given from the first year on will not increase. Another con, unfortunately, good, bad, or indifferent, there will be a GPA requirement, typically a 3.0 or higher. So if your student falls below the 3.0, scholarship money can be taken away. Usually what happens is, though, students will be given a warning, i.e., I guess, probationary period for a semester or so to kind of get back to that 3.0 higher level that's required for the scholarship. Then they keep giving it to the student. But if your student falls below 3.0, gets probation, gets warning, and doesn't get above it, they lose it. And when the student loses the scholarship, it's gone. You cannot get it back. Now, let's talk pros and cons as far as the grant money. When it comes to the grant money, one of the pros right off the bat is if your income and assets stay the same, you can technically get more grant money. Reason being is that if your income and assets stay the same, within the same range, typically, let's say a 5-10% range, what will happen is you're going to be asked to pay the same thing every year based on the financial aid forms, which means you will have eligibility for more grant money, because as your stuff stays even, the college itself, its cost will continue to rise anywhere from typically 3-5%. That means you have more financial aid space created because the cost of the college keeps going up. You have more space to get more grant money. Also, if your income goes down, also creates more grant eligibility. Also, grant money will be given to you as long as you have a 2.0 or higher GPA, where the threshold for scholarship money is typically a 3.0 or higher. Now, let's talk cons, unfortunately, on the grant money. Grant money can be reduced. So if you make a lot more money, your grants can typically go down every year. And if you make too much money, they can be eliminated entirely. So your taxes play a big part as far as the grant side of this whole equation. Another con, unfortunately, on the grant side, not on the scholarship side, because scholarships are typically given by the college, on the grant side, if you are getting federal or state grants, either one of them can be reduced at any point in time. It's not common, but I am seeing a lot of state websites indicating that the fall grant money is guaranteed, but the spring money is not guaranteed. So it could happen where your state funds coming in could actually reduce from what they give you in the fall to what they give you in the spring, obviously creating more of a bill for yourself in the spring, unfortunately. I've never seen this happen before, but of course, we've never been in situations where nowadays, so I have seen it where the states have taken away aid at the last minute right before the fall semester starts. It is rare, but it has happened. This can also happen with the federal government, unfortunately. So now that we've gone over scholarships and grants, the resources, which one's better, essentially the pros and cons. If you do need additional assistance or help, please reach out either email or giving us a call here on the number on the screen. We also have a newsletter that goes out every month. If you want the newsletter, all you need to do is send us an email with the student's high school name, their grade level, and an email where you want this newsletter to go. We send it out via email. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please hit the subscription button if you want to be notified of new videos coming out, and hit the like button. It does help our channel. Once again, my name is Ed Zamora from Principia Prep. Thank you for watching.